Good morning and welcome to Credit Matters TV. Today we are going to talk about a report that S&P has published on the Italian companies operating in financial conditions. The name of the report is Keys for Italy's Corporate Rebound, and it is the first comprehensive report on the Italian corporate sector. We are joined today by Renato Panichi, who's the main author of the article. Good morning, Renato. Would you tell us about the main findings of your report?
Good morning. Let me say first that in this report we analyzed data related to about 2,400 Italian companies, which is a big number. We mainly relied on S&P Capital IQ database, and this is a sample relatively wide as it represents nearly 30% of total Italian corporates by turnover. The main finding, let's say, we saw a significant decline of Italian companies' profitability. We measured this using EBITDA margin, EBIT margin, and return on capital, and we saw that profitability declined since the peak that was in 2007, and we saw the bottom in year 2013. Let's say that the Italian companies suffer more the recession we had in 2012-2013 in Italy compared to the other recession that was in 2008-2009. And this makes a difference compared to Europe, where the 2008-2009 recession was much more an issue for the performance of corporates. Let's say that the performance of Italian companies overall has been worse than Europe as a whole. When we differentiate Italian companies by size, we also see that large companies have suffered higher margin decline compared to SMEs, but at the same time, those large companies maintain still higher margin compared to SMEs. When we differentiate the performance by business sectors, we also see that some sectors, particularly oil and gas, steel and construction material, suffer a very huge profit deterioration, whereas other sectors like business service and healthcare show some resilience.
In your report, you mentioned the presence of aging and a heavy asset base as a constraint for Italian companies. Could you elaborate more on that?
Yeah, this is a key topic for us. After years of low demand, we see that many Italian companies have large balance sheet asset bases relative to current demand. We measure this using total asset to EBITDA ratio, and we saw that for all the companies in our sample, the level at end 2013 was about 12 times, whereas for the same sample, the level in 2006 was 8.4 times. And it is worth saying that when we measure the same ratio for large companies, small companies, and medium companies, we observe that the level is much higher for small companies and medium companies. And clearly, in our opinion, this indicates that there is an excess, let's say, of fixed investing capital, which is also aging, and also large working capital needs. And this is for sure constraining Italian companies' recovery of profitability.
Which are, in your opinion, the main topics for the credit outlook on the Italian companies over the short to medium term?
Well, let's say we expect companies to restructure their asset base and to consolidate their business. If they want to recover profitability and improve their productivity. Let's say structural overcapacity, weak credit metrics and limited demand are present in several sectors in Italy, particularly in heavy industry. And so it is there that we expect companies to restructure and consolidate, in particular, I would say, among small and mid-sized companies. In addition, I would add that for those companies, restructuring and consolidation is a means to improve the competitiveness that suffered a lot in the past few years, particularly by increasing the labor factor productivity and raising the average size of companies.
Lastly, with regards to funding, what is the trend that you see among Italian companies?
Well, using a slogan, I would say companies gradually embrace the capital market. Let's say that the total corporate debt in Italy started to decline in 2012, and this trend gathered pace in 2013. If we measure the total stock of the Italian corporate debt in the period 2012-2013, we see that over this period, 2 years, there's been a decline in absolute terms of about 25 billion. This decline, in effect, is the sum of two different components. On one side, we had a decline of loans, mainly from Italian banks, for 75 billion, which is a relatively high amount. But at the same time, we had an increase in corporate bond issuance for about 50 billion. So the net sum is 25 billion, but as I said, this has two different components. And in our opinion, the financial disintermediation that has started in 2013 is quite positive, and this is something that could help companies, particularly mid-sized companies, to find the means to finance their investments necessary for the restructuring.
Many thanks, Renato. I'd like to remind you that the article entitled Keys for Italy's Corporate Rebound is available on our website, and see you in the next edition.